Hello everyone, welcome to this video. In this video I'm going to tell about how to use Google Gemini API for creating simple web application. Okay, I'm going to make it very simple, keep it very simple. Okay, it is just for explain the concept. Okay, so normally we used to come to this gemini.google.com web page for accessing it, right? We have to enter the prompt here, like tell latest tech news. Okay, so after giving the prompt, it will be processing it and it will be giving the response. It is listing today's tech news. Okay, and if you want to create blog post, you have to just copy and then you can use it on your blog somewhere. Okay. It is the regular procedure, right? But it is having a lot of limitations. Say for example, here you have to visit this website, gemini.google.com, and you need to type the prompt, okay, tell latest tech news, like that. And if you want to get the latest political news, you have to again type tell latest political news, right? And if you want to get the news from last week, then again you need to type that, right? So you have to keep on changing the prompts to get different outputs. Okay, but imagine that you are having some website and you are providing the menu like tech news, political news, sports news, like that. Menus are there, and similarly 2 weeks before, like that menu there, right? So if you click the tech news, it should be showing the latest tech news. Okay, and clicking on political news, if it is showing political news, then it's a very convenient thing, right? So it will help us to save a lot of time. Okay, so for that purpose we can use that API. Okay, so I mean our own web application using that API. So let me show, but I am going to show in a very simple way, but you can just imagine how to expand it, right? And I am familiar with PHP, so I am going to use with PHP sample code. I am not sure whether everyone will be comfortable with that, so I am not going to give any detailed thing. So I decided to keep very simple thing, only the connect API, getting API, sending API request and getting output and showing that. Okay, very simple steps. Okay, but you got the overall view, right? So for our convenience, we can develop our own web application using API. Okay, so that will save a lot of time. And understand that currently API is free, but it is having rate limitation. Okay, so we cannot use it for multiple requests. Okay, so this is Google AI Studio. I already explained about it. Here we are going to get the API key. Okay, so you can visit this website by typing aistudio.google.com. okay, here we have a lot of things. I already explained that. Okay, here now we are going to get the API key. So we have to click this API key. So it will be showing this. I already created API key. So I can just copy that. Okay, and it is providing some sample code using CURL for testing that. You can just try it, or straight away you can create your own code. Okay, so they provided quick start guide. Okay, so all the things are there, sample for various language, Python, Go, node.js, like that. So as I said, I'm going to use PHP is not here, so I'm going to use this REST API, and then I can use that in a PHP code, right? So it is providing that CURL code only, right? So this is the format. Okay, so this is a URL, and it is the content. Okay, it's a data. So I just created one simple PHP file, news.php. okay, so here I need to provide the API key which we generated from Google AI Studio, and we have to mention the prompt. Okay, so I just keep separate variable for that, one for API key, one for prompt. Okay, and we need to provide the JSON data like provided in this format. I just copied this and I just like included that dollar prompt and dollar your API keys, just parameterize that. Okay, so using CURL we can send the request and it will be stored in the dollar response variable. Just I created one simple function. It is a very common function in CURL. Okay, so the core concept is we have to send the prompt, okay, in this specific format. Okay, so that I copied that code from the this guide. Okay, quick start guide. That's it. It's a very, very simple thing. Okay, so if you want tech news, you can mention tech news. If you need political news, you can change here as political news prompt. It is a very simple example. Okay, if you are familiar with style sheet, other things, you can include that also. For the simplicity, I am not providing anything, just sending the request and then showing the response. That's it, just echoing the response. Just so I need to just paste the API key. Okay, so we shouldn't show the API key. Okay, I'm just loading the file from the browser. So it's showing the tech news, right? Microsoft Bing with ChatGPT now available to the public. Apple has launched a redesigned MacBook Air with a larger 15.5 inch screen. Okay, so it is tech news. If you want political news, okay, Biden announces $20 billion in military aid to Ukraine. Okay, so it's showing political news. So we can create a web page and provide menu like tech news, political news, like that. And if you click the tech news, it should be showing tech news like that. We can easily do. Okay, and we have to add styles, other things. Within few minutes we will be able to create a latest news website. Okay, so that is the power of Gemini and its API. Okay, so I hope I cleared the things. So since I provided the API here, I'm deleting it. I deleted the API. Okay, so as I said, it's having write limits, so we shouldn't show the key to others. Thanks.